fellow YouTubers, and welcome to this quick mailbag session, and also where I'd like you to give me some advice on what to do next. And the reason, again, I'm asking for what to do next is that I've got a pile of videos to get through, and I certainly do need help in terms of prioritizing them. And as, in essence, it's your show, it'd be nice to have input from yourself to decide what takes priority and then what falls in behind that. But to start off, first of all, as you'll have seen from the little clip, I had a, call it a gift, that arrived from Hong Kong from one of my viewers called Frankie. He sent me this Mastech MS8218 50,000 count multimeter, and it comes with data logging software as well. So first of all, I certainly want to thank him very much for sending this. He actually started communicating with me when he had seen my review on the Brymon TBM 687 multimeter. He actually went and bought three of them. One he kept for himself, one he gave to a family member, and the other he has on eBay. So I just want to point it out that those Brymons seem to have been very difficult to get hold of. So I'll post a link here, or there'll be a link below to his eBay store if you are interested. I think it's going for $275, which seems to be, again, a very reasonable price for that multimeter. So this multimeter is one of the things which I'll talk about, which will be potentially on the review list in the near future. Now, in terms of the next order of videos, there are a couple of sponsor videos which I would like to do. So that'll include the final video on my solar installation, since I've got it all together. And then I'll be starting the tutorial series for Victron Energy on some of their equipment. In particular, that's the battery monitor. I'll just lean over and grab it. So this battery monitor I was talking about. Now, Andre, the agent for Victron Energy here in Cape Town or South Africa, actually sent me some really interesting information on batteries, their maintenance, the care, charging, discharging, and what potentially destroys them. And again, that gives you a real appreciation for something like a battery monitor, because that can give you a good indication of the health of your battery bank. And if you've made a large investment in a big battery bank, that can be critical. So even though it's a tutorial training video, I think there'll be some very interesting aspects that come out of that video which you might want to follow as well. So there's those two videos which will happen. Now I'm going to list, and what I'll do is down the side here, I'm going to list and name the other videos. And then from those titles, if you can place a comment on which one you would like, or so I'll count either the comment or whether it gets a thumbs up. And whichever ones get the most, those will be placed at top of the order for the next series of videos. So there's the multimeter. So there's two multimeter reviews, either this Brymon TBM 251. I have found, thanks to Retired Caps, there is an equivalent on Amazon. It's the Green Lee DM200A, and I've got that on my Amazon store, but by all means, obviously, wait for the review for that. Then there's obviously the Mastech multimeter, so that'll be a decision between those two reviews. Then there's, I could possibly get a Fluke thermal imager from Comtest. Also, Comtest can probably provide me with a Regal DS2000 series oscilloscope for review. So there's those two items. There's then the series on how to solar power your house, where I'm going to go through several series on how to do that and the considerations. There's then the Arduino tutorials, the electronics tutorials. So I'll list those all down here and take your pick out of those. Then what I also want to bring to your attention is there's another very good viewer of mine. His name's Joshua. I'm going to add a link to his channel up here. He also has done his own version of a electronic DC load. In fact, his is a digital version. I'm going to link to that up here. He's actually sending one of his builds of his electronic DC load down to South Africa so that I can have a look at and play with it, and we'll do a review on that when it arrives. But Joshua's also started a Kickstarter project on an electronics project that he built. It's a mini USB microcontroller host. So I'm going to put a link to the Kickstarter project below and a link to that video up here as well. So if you're interested, I say it's certainly worthwhile going to have a look. It might be something that interests you and you may want to consider backing as well. One other thing I want to add before I forget. Someone asked about a multimeter giveaway, and what I will do is in the coming weeks I will announce another multimeter giveaway and tell you. You would probably have to go to my forum and I'll ask you to answer a few questions or maybe post a few photographs, and it'll either be the Tech Power that I reviewed or the Mastech or the Unity UT61E. Now, I didn't add the UT61E into the list because I don't have it in my hands yet. It might take still a month to get here. But one of these three multimeters or even two of them might be up for grabs on a multimeter giveaway. But that I will announce in a few weeks to come. Again, I thank you very much for your support. Catch you soon for the next video. Cheers.